getting the main stage ready. Party starts tomorrow, actually. It's like maybe 28 hours from now. But they're getting ready. And man, does that stage look beautiful this year. It's going to be a lot of fun. Yeah, the first 2 days of Boom, there's basically no music. The first day, it's everybody just getting in. And even the second day, yeah, I hear a lot of stories with people being trapped at the main gate for 6 to 8 hours. But yeah, 2 days, it hasn't been any music so far. Just getting to know people, swimming in the lake. The food's been great. They got cider and beer for sale. But yeah, tomorrow this thing will officially kick off. Can't wait. So a very important tip, when picking your campsite, get shade. Make sure you find a place with some shade, otherwise it'd be brutal. I finally have a umbrella here to help out, but it's still pretty hot.
Seriously, the most important thing to know is you gotta get a campsite with shade. The people who had shade have no idea what those of us in the sun had to go through. You'll probably want to get here at least 2 days early to get some. I got here 1 day early, and all the good shade and campsites were taken, so I recommend 2 days. Actually, I recommend getting here as soon as possible.
About to start. Here we go. Main stage, about to last off. Boom, 2022.
this was my favorite part of the day right here. Just before sunset, the shade of these trees would form a dance floor, and they'd play some really cool beats. It was a great place to come and hang out, and that's when you knew you survived another day at Boom.
Thank you.
Funky Beach is the place to be between 6 o'clock and sunset, and is a great place to hang out, listen to some chilled out music, have a few drinks, and cool off in the lake. Every day the dance temple takes a 4-hour break at 6 o'clock, and that's when you want to head over to the Funky Beach. So my In the Boom festival went a little strange, and as a result, I was unable to get any video saying goodbye or leaving. So I might as well tell the story of how I left Boom. Well, early in the morning on the last day, just before I was going to wake up and leave, I was woken to a bug crawling inside my ear. By the time I was aware of it, it was too late, already inside my ear. I walked all the way to the first aid tent, which was by the alchemy stage, but they were unable to help. So I got back to camp and quickly packed up everything and got in line for the bus. Every now and again, I could feel the bug in my ear making sporadic crunching sounds, and it was really freaking me out. When the bus to Madrid came, at first they were not even going to let me on the bus because I was wearing a wristband that said Lisbon on it since I came from Lisbon. But I had to explain to them over and over again that I bought the Lisbon to Boom to Madrid ticket. At the last second, I was allowed to get on the bus and began the 5-hour bus ride to Madrid. During the 5-hour bus ride, I was able to Google and read how to handle the bug in my ear. When I got to Madrid, I instantly bought some olive oil and poured it into my ear for 30 minutes to kill the bug. I'm assuming and hoping that did the trick, but yeah, that's how my Boom Festival ended. I survived Boom and lived to tell the story. I hope you all enjoyed the video, and I will see you again next year on the dance floor.